This is Bryce Land from GMN Bearing USA. Today we're going to talk about a couple tips to remember when installing a precision angular contact bearing into a shaft and housing. The GMN recommends using a press fit on the shaft and a slip fit in the housing. What's also important to remember is that the bearing journals themselves need to be hardened and ground with a sufficient shoulder for good load transfer. And when you are installing that bearing on the shaft, use an installation tool that presses against the inner ring of the bearing and press with a smooth, constant motion until that bearing seats properly on the shoulder. What's important to remember is that we want no load going through the balls of the bearing. And when you have that subassembly ready to go into the housing, you can use a similar installation tool, but this time one that presses against both the inner and the outer ring so that when you use that smooth constant motion until that bearing is pushed all the way into that housing shoulder, no load is being transferred through the balls. And once you have that side completely installed, you can use a precision lock nut to hold the bearing in place and support the preload transfer that will be used once the assembly is finished being installed. And once you have the left side complete, you're ready to install the bearing on the right. It's important to remember that that left bearing still needs to be supported both rings, even though that's not pictured in this video. And then on the right side, you can use a similar installation tool, again, that pushes on both the inner and outer ring. Use a smooth, constant motion until that bearing is fully seated so that no load, again, is being transferred through those balls. And once you have your bearing fully installed, you're ready to install that precision lock nut. Here, this lock nut is going to establish a back-to-back preload. And here you can see the load path has been established once that precision lock nut is firmly tightened down. And with that, we have a simple back-to-back rigid bearing assembly. And now these steps can also be used for a spring preload assembly. All we need to do is pull this bearing out. And then add our spring and open up our space for our spring to sit nicely in the housing. And then we can use the same installation tool to push that bearing supporting both inner and outer ring with that smooth constant motion until the bearing is properly seated. Again, supporting that left bearing on both rings. And then that precision lock nut can come back in, gets tightened down firmly. Now we have our load path established for now our spring preloaded simple back-to-back bearing assembly. That is a couple simple steps for bearing installation. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us through our website or through our phone number.